Grandmother speaking, grandmother speaking, come in, baby. Grandmother speaking, grandmother speaking, come in, baby, over.
The groundhogs are already starting to bug us. Baby here, hear you loud and clear. Go ahead, go ahead.
Come on, baby, grandmother's waiting for you. But we want your position in the Rose Code. Go to channel 2, over.
Switch to number 2. This guy below may be bored. They want to play like secret agents. Give me your codes. We in full. Baby speaking, we are 30 miles from point B7, radial scale. Height 12 pentax. Oh. Oh, just 1 minute. We've got a breakdown. I'm cutting until we've checked it out.
It's a fault in the bomb mechanism.
I hope the safety device works. All 4 systems have failed.
What's my top on?
Nothing serious. The bomb will fall into the sea.
That doesn't matter. It's not activated.
Oh. Baby here. Baby here. Calling grandmother. Over.
Grandmother, I hear you. Go ahead, baby. Over.
The reins of the baby's bottle have loosened. It's on the point of dropping. Over.
Will it hold until you get back to the mother? Over.
I don't think so. 4 reins gave out, one after the other. The fruit is ripe. Over.
Maintain your position at B7 until you receive further instruction. Over and out.
Prepare yourselves for a long wait.
For one bomb, more or less, they're gonna have us going flying around in circles, like a couple of clowns.
Yep. Only will drop in any case, with or without orders.
There are various units of the Russian Navy a short distance from the area, and also 3 submarines. Our ships would never reach them in time.
Do you think, General, the Russians know what's happening?
They already know our air codes, and are perfectly aware that the baby's bottle is an atomic bomb with some very sophisticated innovations, and therefore of great military importance.
Obviously, they'd like to get their hands on it, wouldn't they?
We have to prevent that at all costs.
What can we do, sir?
Have them activate the bomb and dump it into the sea.
Order received. Grandmother here, go ahead, baby, over.
Baby's getting dizzy flying around in circles. Tell us, what are we supposed to do now? Over.
Proceed to point B14, radial scale. Uncork baby's bottle and drop it, over.
Are you sure those are the orders? Over.
Mission, uncork, abandon, and return to base. Do not delay. Over and out.
Let's go to B14.
Hey, that's madness, man.
And B14 is near the deepest spot.
We're over the point.
Activated.
Get ready to drop.
Ready.
Drop it. Mission completed. Let's go home.
Thank you. goldfish man?
We went to fish in the usual area. We saw the sea covered with dead fish. They had some unusual sizes and colors that I've never seen before.
Must be some contamination. Well, did you bring some samples to be analyzed?
No, I was afraid.
Afraid? Afraid of what?
We picked up a lot of fish. They were dead. But they seemed to be in pretty good condition, and to check them out, they had some. Seemed okay, but maybe we shouldn't have done it.
What have you done with the rest of the fish?
We threw them back.
Captain, there's a strange light in your cabin.
What are you talking about? I turned the lamp off.
No. It's not light from a lamp. It's dimmer. More like a glow.
Gee, something funny glowing in there.
That's why we threw them back.
Did anyone else see the fish?
No, just a few of them.
Did you have some of that fish?
No.
It could be radioactivity.
Nah, I feel fine. I'm all right.
You never know. You better go to the city for a checkup, yeah?
In a boat?
I'll find someone to take over while you're away.
There's no one available.
There is one.
Pedro Fontan? You trust him?
You call to give me instructions? Get it over with.
I just want to tell you that you're working for me because I couldn't find somebody else.
I know that.
Last time you were saved because of lack of proof. But this time, I'll accept no negligence this time. I'll get the law on you.
Any other warnings?
Nope. Good luck.
That's what I'm hoping to have.
Well, well, Captain. Back at the port again, huh? Didn't expect to see you around these parts.
I've been given command of the Alcantara. I want you to make everything ready. We leave tomorrow morning, dawn.
Want me to lay in a couple of bottles of cognac for you, Captain?
You make sure you get your work done. You might regret it.
Like my brother. He sailed with the captain on the Maria Nina. He regretted it.
It was a shipwreck. Ship run aground. Anyway, it was all clarified at the hearing in court.
Lucky for you, there were no witnesses. They all drowned.
What could they have testified, Linares?
What everyone knows, Captain. You were drunk.
You just make sure everything's ready. Shipshape by 5 o'clock. Not a minute later. Linares! Go down, get some sleep. I'll relieve you.
You're not drunk, are you?
Go to your bunk.
What did we hit?
Did the hull hold out?
No, we're taking out water.
Can we reduce it?
No, we're taking in water faster than we can pump.
Everybody to the lifeboats!
All right, up the stairs. Come on, no, hand it over here. All right, over the top. The rope. First boat, here's the first boat. Watch it. All right, now get the second boat. Get the second boat. Come on. Hand it to me. Over the top. Keep. Here it comes. Take it easy now.
Linares.
Drag them to the bottom.
Keep rowing. Stop making guesses.
Do you mean we're going to save ourselves and let them drown?
If they've been swallowed by the emptiness of the ship, there's nothing we can do to save them.
Sea monster, no less. Couldn't you think of a more natural story to justify the shipwreck?
But I tell you, it is the truth.
What, are you kidding? Nobody saw the monster. And Linares assured us when you took over the helm, you were in a drunken state.
Oh, no, that's a lie!
Is it? Then try to convince the naval commander. This time, it's gonna be very difficult.
What happened when the captain came to relieve you?
He told me he was going to take over the helm.
And you agreed?
At first, I questioned his orders.
Why?
Because he was drunk.
That's a lie. It's a lie.
Silence. Silence.
Please advise your client that he can only hurt his case by impeding the normal procedures of this investigation.
I'm sorry, Commander. It won't happen again.
I trust not. Continue with your questions.
Did you see anything unusual in the sea?
Are you referring to the monster this accused is talking about?
Exactly.
That was only the booze speaking.
I object.
Objection sustained. Please refrain from giving personal opinion. Just answer the question put to you.
Excuse me. There was nothing unusual to be seen at sea. I never saw this monster, and neither did my mates.
I object!
Objection sustained. The witness will please answer only for himself. Do not answer for other witnesses. They shall give their own testimony in due course.
I have no more questions to put to the witness.
Thank you, Counselor. Now the defense.
I understand you harbor a certain resentment toward the accused.
I object.
I think it's important to establish that there's an element of prejudice against my client. And this might influence the testimony of the witnesses.
I'm implying that perjury has been committed in this hearing.
I am simply stating that certain half-truths may have been uttered.
Aren't you forgetting that this witness is testifying under oath?
Silence, gentlemen. Objection overruled. Anything that may be relevant to the understanding of this case shall be given a hearing. Continue with your questioning.
Is it a fact your brother died in the shipwreck of the Maria Nina?
Yes, sir.
And is it also a fact that the Maria Nina was commanded by the accused?
Yes, sir.
I object. The defense counsel is referring to events which have nothing to do with this case.
Objection overruled. Any relationship between the witness and the accused must be considered by this tribunal.
You expect us to believe you bear no grudges against him?
I object. The defense counsel is suggesting bad faith on the part of the witness.
Objection sustained. Have the last statement of the defense counsel stricken from the record.
I have no more questions to ask this witness. Thank you.
The witness may leave the stand. Does the accused wish to add anything?
I only want to point out one thing, which to me seems fundamental because of the future dangers to navigation. And that is, the sea monster. He does exist. I have seen him. It was not a product of nerves or too much confusion in the darkness. He was only a short distance from me. There's not the slightest possibility of error. That I can assure you.
Please, please.
Having heard the prosecution and defense counsel, this tribunal will now withdraw to consider its verdict. The court will reconvene within 2 hours to make that verdict public.
Stand up, please.
Oit to Fred, eight black.
What are you doing with your game?
Terrible. How about you with the roulette?
Lost every cent.
Have you been drinking again?
Just a few gin tonics.
After a couple of cognacs.
Just looking for a change, for some different emotions. This is a secret.
You're out of it.
Don't exaggerate.
Hey, you're gonna fall on your face.
Okay, what do you want me to do about it?
Why don't you go outside and have some fresh air?
And then?
And then I suppose you want me to lend you some more money, right?
I like my millionaire friend. I think I'll go and get some sea breeze. Where's my drink?
You've had enough to drink for tonight, Jill. You can't go on drinking like this.
But I want to break the bank. I'm inspired.
No, you're drunk. That's what you are.
I want to go back to the tables.
Forget it tonight. Come on.
There's not enough oxygen for me here.
You have to breathe deeply.
I breathe, but nothing.
You can't ask for cleaner air. We're right by the ocean.
That's it. The ocean. I'm going to the beach.
What, at this time? Are you crazy?
I want to breathe the salt, the iodine, the seaweed, on the moonlight. It's so romantic.
Jill! Jill!
Hey!
Wait for me!
Catch me if you can!
Don't go so far out!
The evidence heard, this tribunal finds Pedro Fontan Barrios guilty of negligence, causing the shipwreck, and hereby declares him incapable of exercising the profession of ship's captain. His license is thus withdrawn. Likewise, since the defendant may be considered guilty of criminal negligence, this case shall be turned over to the civil tribunals. The case is now concluded.
We shall appeal.
Well, you defended the case like the old tiger that you are.
No, I haven't done a thing. It was a lost cause.
American tourist resides in the psychiatric residence of San Juan de Oso, Lisbon. She insists on seeing a sea serpent.
I think he's trying to pretend he's gone out of his mind.
That will probably be the only defense against a charge of a crime and of negligence.
Even that might prove to be difficult.
The civil lawyers will be able to take care of that one.
Anyway, don't forget you owe me the whiskey we bet on this case.
All right, let's go have it.
Is Miss Margaret Roberts here?
I'm sorry. Visiting hours are only on Thursday from 5 to 8.
It's very important that I see her.
Let me think. I think that, yes, Miss Roberts is under observation.
Well, what does that mean?
She's in isolation until it's been established whether or not she should have contact with the outside world.
Yes, I understand. May I speak with the doctor in charge of her case?
He's gone for the day. Come back tomorrow between 9 and 12. By the way, are you any relative?
No. No, I'm just a friend. What floor was she on?
Second floor. But I told you, you can't see her yet.
Yes, I know. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Morning.
Were you never taught to knock at a door before entering?
Excuse me, I'm in a hurry, but are you Margaret Roberts?
Very obvious who I am. What do you want?
I just want to tell you, I've seen it. I've also seen the sea monster.
What kind of trick is this?
I don't understand.
First, you make an exhaustive study of my entire childhood, of my possible disappointments. Then you try persuasion. Now, little girl, these are just products of your imagination, of your sick little head. Then it's pills and showers and injections, and now you admit I was right. What are you trying to do?
Listen, in the first place, Margaret, I'm not a doctor.
Oh, I can see that.
No, this is just a disguise.
What are you waiting for? You want me to say, I am Cleopatra? Well, where's the tape recorder? Where is it?
You've got to believe me. I'm probably the only person that can prove you're quite sane.
I Are you a patient here?
No. I'm the captain of a fishing boat.
Just as I thought. Completely crazy. Would you please go away?
How can I convince you?
Listen, don't come near me, okay?
The monster has a crest of scales.
Get out of here, or I am going to scream!
Shh.
Wait a minute. Did you say a crest of scales?
Yes. A giant crest of scales all the way down the spinal column. Just like a giant crest.
Did it attack you?
Uh-huh. Oh, its head must have been more than a meter and a half.
It was a very large creature.
Oh, yes, huge. It sank my boat.
With its teeth?
No. It roars just like a bull.
Oh, so, God!
Shh. Keep cool. Keep cool. Shh. Keep cool. Okay.
Why are you so interested in helping me?
To be quite truthful, it's to my own advantage. I lost my ship. I was held responsible for the shipwreck.
They didn't believe you either.
You're the only person that can save me.
And you are the only one who can convince them that I'm not completely mad, right?
That's exactly the situation. What's the matter? What's wrong?
No, just...
No, what's the matter? What's...
You disguised as a doctor and me locked up in this elegant madhouse. What are we supposed to do? Have you thought about that?
For the moment, get ourselves out of here.
You are completely crazy.
Oh.
I see only a piece of clothing I have. They took all my clothes away from me. Anyway, they're not going to let me out of here.
Well, we'll soon fix that. Get up. Come on. Get up. Come on.
Can I help?
Thank you. I can manage this. Thank you.
It's no trouble at all, sweetheart. To the shower?
Yes, to the showers. Yeah.
Your day off?
Thursday.
That's too bad. I get off on Monday.
Oh. Maybe you can swap with somebody else.
Yeah.
Where's the garage here?
At the end of the corridor, you ought to know that.
I have so many things on my mind, you know.
Yeah.
How it is.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Hey, let me help you. Please.
Thank you.
Hey, that nurse doesn't work here.
No keys.
No luck, huh?
No, they're very careful about such details.
Don't you know how to hotwire it?
No idea.
Well, maybe better take the wheelchair.
No, let's try this car.
You're not going to steal an ambulance.
I'm not driving.
You're driving.
No, your life, I'm not going to drive it.
Shh. What are you going to do? Give up the first obstacle. Come on.
And now what do we do?
Well, you're free now, isn't that something?
I'm not complaining. What about your problem?
Well, you do think about other people, huh?
Will you stop being sarcastic and tell me what you think we should do?
I don't know. We need to find somebody, maybe an important man.
Well, suppose we find him, then what?
Convince him of the truth, at least so he'll believe us. Perhaps we can get a lead at the National Library or University.
Well, let's start with the library.
Okay. Wait a minute. Something we have to do first. Come on.
Does it suit me?
It's okay. I would like to have bought the other model, but...
Oh, this will be fine.
Too expensive. Yeah?
Yeah.
Come on.
Excuse me.
Yes?
Do you know if Pedro Fontan is in Portugal?
Yeah, the Portuguese authorities are already advised.
I think I've got a much better chance of finding him. I've got a lot of friends in the area, and I know all the coastal towns.
What can I do for you?
I need money and supplies for the trip.
Because your brother died in a shipwreck?
Because he sank two of your ships. And because he deserves whatever he's got coming to him.
Okay. With one condition.
What did he say?
When you find him, let the authorities take care of him. I'll bet the lot. This time you're gonna lose your shirt. Don't try any bluff. It'll cost you. Full house. Queens and tens. Straight flush. You've been cheating, and you'll pay for it. Now it's my deal. You're gonna lose everything you won. Hey, what was that?
Did you hear that? Strange sounding siren. They don't know what to invent next. Must be one of those new ships. What the hell is that? Here of the Lacedo Lighthouse. I said Lacedo. The lighthouse is moving. Huh? When was I warned about an earthquake? They warned me about the mist, but said nothing about an earthquake. I could have gotten away in the launch. Hello? Hello? Naval Command? The cable must have broken. We have to get the flare. You wait here, just in case they call me back.
Hurry up. We are closing. What are you looking for? You've been here all morning consulting at the books, and you haven't made up your minds.
Well...
We're looking for a marine biologist or a professor. We're not sure.
Oh, we're from the television, and we're preparing a documentary on sea pollution.
I see.
See?
I think you should speak to Professor Wallace of the National Institute of Oceanography. He's the zoologist and something more.
Oh, yeah.
Where can we locate him?
He spends the mornings at the Museum of Natural Sciences. He's in favor of conservation, I think. But I don't think he'll pay much attention to you.
Why is that?
Well, he's rather a strange man. They say he's a bit mad.
And who do you intend to deceive with this story?
Professor, I assure you, we've seen it.
Yes, I know. Thousands of ships crossing the Atlantic. Planes flying, submarines, And yet you two have been privileged to view this beautiful beast. Now, can you explain that?
No. And I wish we'd never come across it.
Ah. I wonder how much they pay you to ruin my good name.
Professor, we're not from the television.
So the story is not true. The beast is not a monster.
Unfortunately, the part about the monster is true.
Listen, don't run that thing into the ground anymore. I'm a very busy man. I have at least 3 skeletons in the next room that I have to take care of.
Professor,
please.
Do you think you know everything?
No, not everything. But I know a great deal more than those academic wizards downstairs.
Well, is it possible then that there's something you don't know about yet?
Like what?
Well, like a sea monster.
Not that again.
But we've seen it! Even if you don't believe us, even if nobody believes us...
I always thought a scientist first examined something before rejecting it.
All right, you win. I'll examine your monster. Did you bring it with you?
Of course not.
Did you take any photographs?
No, we didn't photograph it.
Then what do you want me to examine? How can you demonstrate to me that this animal existed? If you have no proof.
We cannot demonstrate it to you right here and now, of course. You have to believe us.
Why? Because you've got a pretty face?
Oh, Jesus.
There's nothing we can do. Wait.
What's this?
Read it.
You're in an insane asylum?
Yeah.
You must have imagined the whole story.
Professor, it sank my ship.
Are you trying to tell me that the monster...
Yes.
Yeah.
It charged the boat several times.
A lighthouse was destroyed last night in the area. Just a mist.
What's that got to do with it?
There may be a connection. That is, if you two are not lying. Come on.
My ship was wrecked approximately here.
That's just what I wanted to know. And where did your incident take place?
In Estoril. Right about down
I
there.
I know where Estoril is. And that's where the lighthouse was burned down and destroyed.
Professor, do you think there might be a connection?
Well, recently there's been another event that hasn't been fully explained. About 10 days ago, a huge number of fish were found floating on the surface of the sea, covering an area of several square miles. Now, it might have been a broken barrel containing radioactive material that had been thrown in the Atlantic.
I know. It happened 2 days before my ship sailed.
Were any of those fish analyzed?
No. Thrown back into the sea. They were afraid it might be radioactive contamination.
Well, that adds up. A few days ago, the British Admiralty reported an explosion at the bottom of the sea. It had all the characteristics of an atomic bomb. The fish surfaced here and is going in this direction, following the current toward the African coast. He's very irritated and he attacks anything that approaches him. It's curious. But all the old sea charts of the Atlantic Ocean showed pictures of serpents, the legendary Thinnath Serpe. Sea captains saw it. Lieutenants of corvettes affirmed they'd seen it. And yet, nobody will accept it. They just won't accept it.
Well, do you believe us now?
Huh, what?
Do you believe us now?
Oh, yes. But what's the point? What's the point of having another candidate for the lunatic asylum?
I'd like to get out of this business.
What's so bad about it?
Too risky. We're always risking our necks.
And what else do you know how to do?
I'd like to be a lifeguard on some beach.
Yes, I could just see them giving you that job.
Why not?
That's not for a fisherman. That's for playboys, sportsmen.
There's nothing wrong with this business, so far. But one fine day, the police might catch up with us.
Don't talk like a Jonas.
Come on, just keep rowing. Let's get this thing over with. Hey, look at that. What is it?
It looks like a submarine.
Come on, row faster, come on! Come on! Come on! Come on, come on! Come on!
Let's hope somebody will listen to the professor.
Do you think they will?
It's funny.
What's so funny?
You and me. Both come from a different social class, different meaning in life. We both depend on one another. Because we're the only witness to this incredible event. Lead me to prison, you to an insane asylum.
We're stuck here in Lisbon, waiting for the monster to attack again. According to the professor, it will pass through this area.
So, what else can we do?
But must we wait in this hole until they hunt us down without defending ourselves?
Well, you have a better suggestion. Go on, tell me about it.
But if we don't try to do something, we're not going to get anywhere.
Well, let's be realistic. Let's not complicate our situation any further.
Oh, cheer up. Everything's going to be fine.
Did you convince anybody?
No. I tried, but nobody listened.
But why all this optimism?
Well, yesterday a smuggler's boat was sunk under strange circumstances. As always, misty, calm sea, but a collision with another vessel was out of the question, which proves that our monster's attacked again, which means that he's following his southerly course. Now, didn't I say he would pass near here?
Yes, but no one will believe it.
But some wood was found near the port.
But what does that prove?
Wait a minute. There was a survivor.
Yes?
A survivor? Has he talked yet?
No. He was unconscious when they picked him up. And he's still unconscious. although he's getting better every moment.
So what are we doing sitting here twiddling our thumbs?
You'd better remain hidden. You might be recognized. The police have broadcast your descriptions.
What does it matter if there's another survivor?
But it does. It means that the three of us have seen the monster now.
Don't be so hasty. The launch may have been wrecked by normal circumstances.
We know that's not the case.
Let's suppose, just for an instant.
Doesn't matter. We want to go with you.
We'd prefer to do anything rather than staying and hiding here.
You're risking too much.
We're well aware of the risks.
Dr. Moore, put me through to the room with that shipwrecked sailor that was brought in yesterday.
I'll connect you with room 15. Hello? Yes, Dr. Moore. The patient? He's in the same condition. He doesn't talk, but I think he's making progress, apart from shock.
There's an ambulance on its way with several victims of a traffic accident. Leave the patient that you're attending and start preparations for emergency surgery at once.
But you gave instructions to me to keep a constant watch over the patient.
This is an emergency.
Whatever you say, doctor.
Great piece of strategy, yes. New launch, capsizes on a perfectly calm sea. Now you're here, done with shock. Just great. What happened to the others? And the goods? All at the bottom of the ocean? You must think I'm stupid. You expect me to believe this shit? Where are the other two hiding out? You know, I've got a lot of patience, and I'd like to stay here playing games with you, but I just ain't got time. Where's the merchandise? You stupid, stupid bastard. You know, I've got a lot of interest in these parts. But if my partners find out what you tried to do to me, they just might try and do the same. Sorry, but I've got to make an example out of you. My boys will take care of the other two.
Dr. Moore.
Good afternoon.
Have you only just arrived?
Of course.
Then you didn't advise us there was an ambulance on its way here?
What are you talking about?
So, it wasn't him.
Stop talking nonsense.
Excuse me. Do you have a shipwrecked sailor hospitalized here?
Yes, but this is not the visiting hour. Apart from that, the poor man can't speak.
What's wrong with him?
Shock. His two companions were killed in the shipwreck.
Well, perhaps I can help him. Recover his speech, I mean.
Are you suggesting he's not receiving proper attention in this hospital?
Oh, not at all, sir. No. You see, I happen to be a marine biologist, and I thought I might be able to help him with his problem.
All right, all right. Come along
Thank
with
you.
Me. I brought some people that want to talk to you. Haven't you anything to say to them? A greeting? Anything?
We've seen it. The same as you. Listen, we're on your side. We must warn the people about the danger.
What danger is he talking about?
Damn it, answer me. This man is...
What's the matter?
He's dead.
Huh?
He's dead.
Now what?
If that is so, what can we do now?
Get out of here.
Good God.
Now what?
He's been murdered. It was done with his pillow.
How can you be so sure?
When a person is killed by smothering him, it's impossible to avoid the upper teeth leaving a mark on the lips. We must get him. We could call the police.
Well, since you won't be needing us anymore, I must thank you for your kindness. Of course, it's a pity.
No, you're not leaving.
Oh, but it couldn't have been us. We came up with you, remember?
Of course, of course. But the police will want to know why you have so much interest in talking to him and the danger you're talking about.
Ah, well, that sounds reasonable. So we'll stay, won't we?
Oh, we can't stay with him.
Miss, I'm Dr. Moore. Let me have the police.
Porto! How's it going, Porto?
Well, look who's here. Well, what brings you to these parts, my boy?
Porto, I'm looking for a man.
You... you sure is not a woman you're looking for?
I'm looking for a fishing captain. Name of Pedro Fontaine. He left Galicia about 3 days ago.
Oh, a Galician seaman with a mad woman was seen on the coastal docks.
Yeah?
He took her out of an insane asylum. Made quite a stir. It was in all the papers.
When were they seen?
Oh, yesterday. They hid among the crates on the docks. Who knows what they were up to?
Didn't you hear that?
That's your hangover.
I'll have a hangover tomorrow. You want a shot?
No. Have a good night on watch.
Thank you, Gallego. With this, I never spend a bad night on watch. There's a launch approaching. Yes, I actually can see it. Without lights, don't know where these idiots think they're going.
Stay warm, old man.
Jenny, it will fall if you breathe on it. Hey! Hey! You guys on the launch, be careful!
You are going to ram the jetty!
Damn you, you stupid fools, you!
Answer me, damn you! Don't try to fool me! I know you are there!
Jesus! What's that?
My God.
God, help me.
This is it. This is it.
This? What's in there?
Oh, all sorts of things. Ropes, cables, tar, sails, compasses, sextants, sirens, buoys, all sorts of things.
So what are we going to do with all that stuff?
Now, just a moment, my impatient friend. There are also flare pistols in there.
Flare pistols?
Yes.
What for? Are you thinking of having a party?
We have no other defense.
Okay, so, what you're saying is our only means of defense is in there, right?
All we have to do is to get in there and take them.
Okay, let me have the key.
I don't have a key, but I have this. You see, this particular storeroom belongs to Naval Command, and people from Naval Command do not get along with people from Oceanography. It's a pity, but there it is.
Naval Command? Oh, that's wonderful. Wonderful.
Oh, come on. Look at it. One good push, and in we go. You're a strong young man. Just takes a little effort, that's all.
This is it, right? We have to break in?
Unless you can think of another way. We've got to get those flares. There's still time to forget the whole thing.
Go on, let's get it over with.
Yes.
Just a little effort, right?
Well, nothing works out right the first time.
Afternoon.
Well, well, well. It's our fugitive from justice. Some newfound friends. Breaking into a store, huh? You're making real progress.
You hate me enough, Linares, to have followed me all the way down here?
Yeah. First I thought I'd just track you down and bring you in.
Now you found me, you're gonna handle it yourself, is that right?
No. No, that's not it.
Well, what is it then? Come on. Say it.
I've seen the monster. He came up in a ship that old Porto was guarding. He attacked it. Destroyed everything. Porto's dead.
We have another witness.
Before anything else, Pedro, I've got to apologize to you. I should have believed you.
Forget it. If I was in your place, I'd have done the same thing.
Thanks.
Anyway, this whole thing is just crazy.
Well, am I believing anything? It's not going to help solve this. What are you going to do?
Fight alone. Nobody will believe us. If we told our story, there's some rooms waiting for us up in the mental hospital.
You're going to fight that thing? With what? How?
With flare pistols.
You're going to use flare pistols against that? You're crazy.
We only want to scare it. We mean no harm to the creature. We just like to persuade it to go somewhere else, that's all.
Okay. Okay. Count me in.
No. It's between it and me.
Come on. At least give me a chance to make up for some of the trouble I caused you.
Another hand would be most helpful. We could share the work. Now, you and I will get the flares.
All right. One way or another.
And you two, go down and wait at the foot of the stairs near the little boat. And wait for us.
This must be the boat.
Are you sure you want to do this?
I'm just as deep in this as you are, you know. Maybe even more.
Yeah, I know. But we started this together, and that's how I want us to finish it.
Okay, but you are aware of what's waiting for us out there.
I can handle it.
You're a hard case.
Well, yeah, I've always done what I felt like.
Yeah, you're a spoiled kid. And now you want to go out and have a little adventure.
No. What I want now is to put my arms around you.
What?
Why not? This might be our last chance. If the hunt turns out bad.
Even if it turns out okay.
But why? I mean, if we can get through this, you know.
No, we can't. You go back to your life. There's no room for me in it.
Maybe we can work it out another way.
Forget it. There's no way.
And who's being the hard case now, huh?
You'd have to give me a very good argument to change my mind.
Oh, really? How about this?
I guess it's not such a bad moment for a little affection.
No, just ignore them. I've seen it coming for a long time. Just get in the boat, that's all.
Well, I guess we can just leave them here and do it ourselves.
We're always going to be arguing, Linares.
At your orders, Captain. But I'll never understand how, with a girl like that, you want to go chasing after an overgrown worm.
What? Dynamite?
Well, you never know. I think it's about time.
So what do you have in mind, Professor?
Well, the first thing is we'd better attract him with the flares. Then we'll try and lure him over toward the bridge.
Why the bridge?
Well, I'm hoping he'll get trapped trying to get through the beams.
He might catch us.
What, with our trusty gasoline-powered engine?
Well, I'm not really sure, but he looked pretty fast to me.
Yeah, I saw him swimming real fast, too.
Well, if he gets too close, there's always the dynamite. So it's up to you.
It's worth the risk.
Yep.
And you, my dear?
I say we go slay the dragon.
Bravo. I never expected anything less from you. So, avanti.
Professor, you tell me when to turn.
You maintain this present course. If I see something, I'll let you know.
You were right about the raincoat, Professor. Without it, I would have been frozen by now.
Well, I'm usually right about something sometimes. Stop the motor.
Okay.
This is a good spot. I'll get your gun ready.
The patrol boats might see us. We're too close to the port.
I can't even see the lights.
What if he's not around here?
But you saw his trail on the map. He has to stay close to shore. He can't get too far, and these flares can be seen for miles around.
Let's hope he sees it before the harbor patrol does. See anything?
Looks like we'll have to use another one.
No. Maybe he's all the way over by Point San Vicente.
And you stand by to start the motor immediately.
Harbor Patrol is bound to see us.
Stand by the motor.
Hurry up.
Start the motor.
Hurry up.
Hurry up.
Head for the coast. Faster. Faster.
That boat. Get a little closer. It's hard to see in the night.
Let's go closer.
Drinking. I'm gonna take a picture now.
In this light?
Get closer for a picture.
Look, the air patrol.
They've seen us.
I didn't count on the air patrol.
Can't you get closer?
It's dangerous.
Go!
Jody, maybe we can scare it.
Thank you.
Get away!
According to my calculations, our monster's on his way to Africa, preferably Libya. And I think you'll catch a ride on the Gulf Stream, right down to the Caribbean, near Florida, or to Havana.
Yeah, and so?
And I figured we'd get a torpedo boat and follow him.
Well...
Where the hell are you gonna get a torpedo boat?
I know there are hundreds
of them. No, thank you!
Forget it! Bye!
Hey, don't go! Wait a minute!
Not this time!
And not the next time either!
Youth. No spirit of adventure.
Professor, where are you gonna get the boat?
Very easy. The United States Navy, they have hundreds of them. They never miss just one.